Cut! That does it, boys. You okay?
Sure.
Well, there's another picture in the bag. When are you leaving?
Right away. I'm making my 10th anniversary broadcast from the ranch.
Roy, you can be mighty proud of your 10 years in pictures. You've made millions of friends all over the world.
Hey, Roy, sing Dust, that song you sang in your first picture. You know, we haven't heard that in a long time.
Okay, Joe, I'll remember.
Well, good luck and have a nice trip. We'll all be listening to your broadcast. Well,
thanks, Paul.
You bet.
Figure easy, boy. We'll see you.
Come on, Roy.
Come on, Roy.
The mighty king would stoop to meet us.
Huh? Let's hail the conquering hero, for it's time he did appear.
And with reverence, we proudly say,
long live the king.
He's here. He's risen to Rogers, the king of the cowboys, the bravest man upon the silver screen.
Whenever there is trouble, there comes Trigger on the devil.
To link the bell and pass and steal the sea. He's got away with women too. How they cuddle up to him.
When the director tells them to.
He's Rootin' Rogers, the king of the cowboys.
The bravest,
bravest, in the fight, the strongest, roughest, in the toughest.
Let me mention, he's a singer, this too.
But is he the same old frog that he was?
Some of you boys take Trigger out of the trailer. Put the car in the garage.
Oh, you might as well saddle him up. We'd like to kind of stretch your legs a little bit.
All right. Now, come on, come on, come on, come on. Get away. You can meet Roy Rogers later. Come on, now.
Who was it, Cookie?
Huh? Oh, no. Didn't nobody. Roy, nobody. Well, we sure have missed you around here, too, Roy. You just never know how we... Oh. Roy, that's just some extra help that I hired so cheap I couldn't afford not to, really.
Well, they're certainly well fed.
Yeah, they're great big... Oh, Mr. Rogers, Cookie promised to introduce us after we took our naps. Didn't your cousin Cookie?
Cousin Cookie, huh?
I guess I can't deny it, Roy. It runs in the family. That's Alf and Luke and Grover Blue Feature.
Cookie, if you don't quit hiring your relatives...
Well, Roy, after their mama died...
We'll never be able to be yours.
I know.
By the way, Cookie, did you ever hire that horse trainer I asked you about?
Oh, but... Yeah, you know, Roy, that's something else I wanted to talk to you about. Well, look at that. There's a little dog.
Hey, that bus that's been rounding up range horses is over in the north pasture.
Oh, who is it, Cookie? Oh, some strangers butchering up them range horses for meat and hides.
That's what happened to the buffalo.
Yeah, but this is legal and it's hurting our army contract.
It isn't legal if it's on our range.
We'd better get over and see if there's no double R horses, Miss Bunch. Thanks, cousin.
here?
Running wild horses, if it's any of your business.
Yeah.
Well, well, I might have known. Roy Rogers, the movie cowboy.
Yeah, yeah.
Pretty brave with all your friends backing you up.
Hold it. Stay on your horses. I'll see that this is on the up and up. I got some work to do.
Take it easy, fella. You're not hurt so bad. Come on now, on your feet. Lead the rest of your pals back out on the range. Come on, fella.
Took a licking. That's Roy Rogers. And Trigger. I read the movie magazine. Roy would sell him for $1 million.
Yeah, I know that. Get on your horse.
He gave you a nice lesson in the manly art of self-defense, too.
Where were you?
Just watching. You were a sucker for those lips.
You see, we can use that money, Captain.
Yeah, now, fellas.
Hey, you're getting awful touchy.
Well, I'm sober.
Where were you when I was taking that beating?
Yeah.
If we lose that herd, the hide contract is gone and so is the money.
Oh, take it easy. We're going to do something about it.
But what about the horses? We'd better round them up before Rogers gets everybody thinking his way and they run us out.
Range horses? Well, that's just chicken feed. I'm thinking about now is one horse.
Yeah, but Rogers.
You're Roy Rogers.
The smartest horse in pictures.
Say.
Get that flea-bitten Australian coyote out of here.
Tramp! Come come here.
Haven't I told you not to come in here when we're busy?
I know, but it's way past lunchtime and I'm hungry.
Here, get yourself something to eat.
Thanks. Come on, Tramp.
Here, come back here with that. That dog steals everything around here. I can't even find my new sales staff anymore.
Let me handle this. Told you before, take him out and get rid of him before I do it for you.
But I'll break him up stealing, Lige. You learned.
So take him out and get rid of him.
Sure, Lige. Sure.
Between that dog and that stepson of yours, my patience is wearing out.
Don't worry about him. I'm shipping him off pronto. I hope he didn't hear that crack about Triggers.
Well, Junior, you look nice enough to go to church. Going out of all your clothes.
Help! You got the place looking good, Cookie.
Help!
Hey, what's up?
Seven kids and...
Captain Cookie, I'm sorry. It was another mouse.
I thought it was. Carolyn, meet your boss. Roy Rogers?
Yeah. Roy Rogers? Oh!
Not again.
But it's the first time she ever seen a movie star.
I can sure tell she's your relation. She weighs a ton.
Oh, she ain't so big.
How old did you say she was?
Well, let's see. When I landed, I don't rightly remember.
Well, you know how we tell the ages of horses, don't you?
You mean look at her teeth?
Right.
No. I can't imagine her being afraid of a mouse. Why a bullfinch ain't afraid of anything on four legs?
Western prairie, the cowboy sat a smoking and dreaming about his Mary. The coyote started howling with his nose pointing to the moon. For a while the cowboy listened, then heard him sing this tune.
You're a nice little coyote, you prowl around and howl around the moon all night. You're a sharp little feller. You better rock and yell about it till my life. And you always sound so lonesome. It makes me a little bit blue. But I ain't got time for prowling or to do a little howling.
Trigger.
Oh, I was winning.
Oh, no wonder you're winning. Trigger's standing there telling you what to play. Business deal? Do you generally go around making business deals in one boot?
Oh, no. I just listened to the song when Tramp took it. He's always doing things like that.
What's the matter, son? You hurt yourself?
No, not lately. A horse kicked me 2 years ago. Doc Richard said I needed an operation. Ryan said my leg will have to get well by itself.
Where do you live?
Well, right now I've found a place I like, got a job.
That sounds to me like a hint.
Well, I thought Mr. Rogers might need an assistant. Somebody has to shine his guns.
So that's the business deal. Well, I think maybe we could use another hand and his dog. Thanks, Pete. That is, if he isn't running away from home. How about it, fellas?
Well, sure, Honor.
Who is this Lige fellow you spoke about?
Well, he's my stepfather. He works for Mr. Jordan down in Saddleback, catching wild horses. But he won't mind.
Well, I'll phone down and see what I can find out. In the meantime, how about some chow, Carolyn?
Okay. Ted, you better come along with me. You could stand a little... Well, you know what they say about cleanliness.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Rogers.
Well, now that you're working for me, just call me Roy.
You call me Ted.
That's it, Ed.
Come on, Tramp. Maybe we can even find a bone for Tramp.
McFarland works for me.
Yeah.
No, he ain't right now. I'll sure tell him when he comes in. Well, thanks for calling. Goodbye. That kid of yours up to Rogers Ranch asking for a job.
Well, that's the last time you'll pull that trick. I'll go up and get him and give him a tale you'll never forget.
Just a minute, Lige. You ain't telling nobody. We want him to get that job. Whether you know it or not, the boy just done us a big favor.
Yeah. Maybe he can help us on that Palomino horse trading deal we're thinking about.
That's right.
Gonna stick around for the big horse race? Who do you think will win? The world's fastest dog or the world's fastest horse?
You better bet on my side, Carolyn. Tramp told me he was ready. Didn't you, Tramp? You'll be the official starter, Cousin Cookie.
Sure, Cousin. Oh, now, wait a minute, Roy. You can tell by looking at him, he's not one of us. We were bigger than that when we were born. Now get in there and start the race for him. Get on your marks. Get fat. Go.
Stretch.
better hurry up. This is the home stretch. Attaboy, Trigger. See, I told you so.
Well, Trigger won, but it was fair and square. I'm not mad at you. Come on, Tramp. Come on, Tramp.
Tramp, that was a good try.
Roy?
Mm-hmm.
You know why Trigger won?
Why?
Because you can holler, come on, louder than I can.
Trigger's legs are a little bit longer, too. How about taking a long ride on the winner? Hi, Pop.
Roy, boy, how be you? Glad to see you back.
Good to see you, too, Pop.
Hi, Ted. Is everything okay?
Sure, Lodge. I'm fine. Roy's giving me a job on the ranch.
This is Lodge McFarland, the boy's stepson.
Hi, how are you? That's mighty nice of you, Mr. Rogers. I'm pretty busy, and Ted and I have been batching him. Sometimes he gets a little out of line, but if he wouldn't be in your way, always room for one more.
You mean I can stay? You're not mad at me for...
Run away? No, no.
There won't be any more running away, will there, Ted? I'll see that he scrubs behind his ears.
You know, that's mighty handsome of you, Miss Carolyn. A woman's influence will probably do the boy a lot of good.
This is the famous Trigger.
Roy, I won't apologize for that cowpoke of mine slugging that horse. I fired him as soon as I found out about it.
Tramp!
Yeah, you thieving mongrel, come back here, Roy.
Hey, Pop, please, I'll get him.
You better. Take it easy, Pop.
Why, you just a puppy. Let him have his fun.
You're a good boy, Ted. Do what Mr. Rogers tells you. There's your stuff.
By the way, you know you're both invited to Roy's anniversary broadcast tonight, don't you?
We'll be there, sure, Miss Caroline. Or bust a cinch. 10 years, huh? Boy, we'll put on a wing day.
It's so pretty, I kind of hate to cut it.
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. This beautiful anniversary cake here on the table in front of us is too beautiful to cut. But we've got to get on with the proceedings here. So while the guests in the ranch living room are being served this anniversary cake, we're going to call upon Roy to give us one of the songs that helped make him King of the Cowboys. Ladies and gentlemen, Roy Rogers.
Dust in the sky, dust on the trail, dust in my eyes,
dust, dust.
Can't see the sun, can't find my way, the dust has won. The cattle and the sheep, bedded down to sleep, seem to realize their fate. Vultures in the sky, though the time is high, will they fly away or wait?
Oh, please ease my pain. Oh, Lord, where is your rain?
And sunshine,
dust,
must it be, can it be eternity, oh Lord, have mercy on me.
Oh, please ease my pain.
Oh Lord, where is your rain and sunshine?
Dust,
must it be? Can this be eternity?
we'll meet again.
This is Roy Rogers saying goodbye and good luck, and may the good Lord take a liking to you.
Thanks, Roy. We return you now to our main studio.
That's a pretty good-sized piece of cake you got there.
Yeah, you ought to get yourself some.
Yeah, we will. Say, where'd you get that fancy shirt?
Oh, it's Roy's. He loaned it to me for the party. He says I'll grow into it.
That looks 50. Let's grab us some.
I'll bet you Trigger'd like some. Let's go see.
Something to happen to Trigger and your friend Rogers, you're going to keep your little mouth shut. Get that?
Yes, sir.
You just came down here and Trigger was gone. That's all. You never saw anybody, remember?
No, sir. I didn't.
That's a smart boy. If you ever crack one word, I'll shoot your head off. Don't forget that. And that goes for your friend Rogers and Trigger. Don't try and holler for help, because I'll be right outside the door.
Trigger? I don't dare tell him.
search for Trigger is being continued by plane, automobile, and horse. And the sheriff has announced that no stone will be left unturned in the hunt. Although it is feared that Trigger has been stolen and may be held for ransom, no contact has yet been made with the abductors.
They'll be contacted soon enough to let them store their own juice for a while.
Says that ought to do it. We got Trigger. You can have him back for $100,000. A dead horse is no good to you or me. Have money in small bills. Instructions will follow. Act fast and don't fool around.
Sounds like it, Rose.
Sure, that's the way we want to settle. Might as well bring him in. It's no use in watching any longer. I guess we're safe now.
Call the studio today, and they've arranged to have the $100,000 here the first thing in the morning. You know, I've got a hunch of somebody that knows us pretty well. It was such a smooth job. They must have been watching us all the time.
If we had just one clue, if Ted had gotten there a second sooner, he could have had a good look at them.
Yeah. How was the kid?
Not so good. He had quite a scare. He wouldn't go to bed till I told him what was in the ransom note. And the part about Trigger really upset him.
Maybe I better go have a talk with him. How about a lullaby, Cookie?
Sure.
What's the matter, Ted? Can't sleep? I'm having the same trouble. How you doing, Tramp? Good boy. Here, let me give you a hand.
Ted, are you sure you told me everything you saw at the barn that night?
Uh-huh. Everything.
What's the matter?
Splinter.
I can fix that. You know, Ted, anything you could remember might give me a clue. You want to get Trigger back, don't you?
Oh, yes, more than anything.
Couldn't you? Ted, there's boys all over the world who would like to help you right now. But you're the only one who can. If you know anything, anything at all, don't be afraid to tell me.
I will. I want to tell the truth.
Sure you do. If everybody would tell the truth, this would be a much better world to live in. You try to go to sleep.
Sure, Roger.
Don't worry about a thing.
They're not worried or they wouldn't be singing.
Means
it's time.
settled town. So settle out your broken drift away. It's time you load into the shadows, little settled
sleepy too. Think I'll turn in and save my strength for tomorrow.
Yeah, me too.
Don't anybody move. Nobody's gonna get hurt. I just want to talk to you.
What about?
I know where Trigger is.
Trigger?
It won't cost you $100,000 to find out. $10,000 is my price.
How can you prove it?
I thought you'd ask that. Take a look at this.
Doesn't necessarily prove anything. A lot of horses have white manes and tails. Where is he?
First, the 10,000.
Okay, you'll get it. But first...
Saddle up!
Listen, I wonder why they shot me.
Because it was double-crossing.
Double-crossing who?
I wish I knew.
We haven't got a chance of...
Morning, Sheriff.
Morning, John. You're right on time.
You've been sitting here all night?
No, I pressed the bars on the window and the burglar alarm.
Well, I guess that $100,000 the vault would buy the place.
Yeah, I guess to buy it.
Ted, I've been a bank for a while. Move and get yourself an ice cream cone.
Thanks, Roy.
You again. Nice trip, nice trip.
Hi, Pop.
Howdy, son.
Where's Roy?
Oh, hi, Raj. He just went to the bank. Somebody shot Ed last night up at the ranch.
Well, you don't say.
Yeah. He was just about to tell us where Trigger was, and they shot him in the back. You supposed to hurt Trigger?
Oh, as long as they get the money, I think the horse will be safe.
If they don't, it'll probably be the end of them.
Well... Roy's in the bank now getting $100,000.
Well, in that case, Ted, you ain't got anything to worry about. Sit on Pappy's knee and I'll tell you all about it. You see, it's like this. Roy goes into the bank, he gets the $100,000, he gives it to these folks, and Trigger's okay.
Sure. That's all they gotta do is give the money to the people that did this. Are they treating you all right up there, Ted?
Sure, Lodge.
Well, that's good. If they don't, you just let me know.
Come on, Tramp.
Beautiful. Hi, Sheriff.
Hello, Roy.
I guess you can see I got the money.
Yeah, the studio shipped it in last night by special messenger. My duty to check up on things like that.
place?
Mm-hmm.
Taxpayers think it's a good idea if I don't go for protection.
Well, I'm a taxpayer, and I think it's a pretty good idea, too. Let's go. Is Pop Jordan selling ice cream cones now?
No, Roy. I wasn't hungry. So I went over to say hello to Pop and wife.
Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, get in.
This evening, saving the moon is shining bright. We're just under water, and the one I want is uttering on the California star.
Hi, Carolyn. Yeah, I'm sure missing my big opportunity. I was going to sell Roy a song for his next picture, but Trigger's got me so upset that boots and saddles just sound like a lot of work.
Sounds kind of pretty to me.
Hey, here's something that came in the mail that looks plenty interesting.
It looks just like the other one.
Yeah.
Hi. Hey, Roy. Roy, this just came. I think it's from the same fellas. Well, open it.
Trigger's safe. Follow instructions carefully. Be at Twin Rocks tomorrow and sign up with money. Put in saddlebags, turn horse loose. If you follow, you will be shot, so will Trigger. Well, at least Trigger's safe. We know what to do.
Yes, if you can believe it.
I'll sure be glad to see that horse again.
You see, Ted, by tomorrow we'll have Trigger back.
I think the money will be safe here till tomorrow, Sheriff. If anything goes wrong, I'll give you funds.
If I were you, Roy, I wouldn't bother. Because we're going to forget about this ransom note and not pay the money.
Now, wait a minute, Sheriff. Trigger means more to me than any amount of money.
I'm sorry to admit, but there's more to this than just getting Trigger back. A man's been murdered, and there may be more. That money stays right where it is. There's still law and order in this county. The apprehension of murderers and blackmailers come first. Can't you see if we let this bunch of outlaws get away with this, it will only serve to encourage them and others to pull the same trick again. No one will be safe.
But these men are dangerous. They'll kill Trigger if they don't get their money. Yeah, but the money's...
Shh. Naturally, I'm going to do all I can to prevent that. And I'll need help from all of you.
I think you can count on me. I'm sorry, Sheriff. I guess I just didn't realize. You know how much Trigger means to me. But if that's the way you want it, that's the way it's got to be. What's your plan?
That's the spirit. I'm with your boys and have them meet me here tonight. Now, here's the plan I have in mind. By daylight tomorrow morning, we'll all be staked out in a big circle around Twin Rocks. When Roy turns the horse loose with the fake money, one of us will be able to keep our eye on him at all times without following him and jeopardizing Trigger. Give the horse a good start and follow him at a safe distance. If anything happens, fire a shot and we'll all come running. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
All right, saddle up. Boy, don't forget your little package.
I won't.
Hey, Pat, saddle up for me, will you?
Under California stars, from far across the valley,
come home, some cowboy song. He's waiting for the daybreak when he'll up and move along.
Package of fake money you asked me to make up is in the drawer. You got time to try a chorus?
Why not?
Say, but ain't it peaceful out tonight?
That's all right.
Did you really like the song, Roy?
Song? Sure.
Did you like it enough to use it in your next picture?
Well, it wouldn't be.
Oh, gee, then you'll use it. Oh, that's swell.
Well, wait a minute. Who wrote it?
A relative. A cousin of mine by the name of Bullfincher. Cookie Bullfincher.
I enjoyed that, Roy.
Gee, it was beautiful.
You think so, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You're fired.
Oh, Roy, you can't fire me. My cousins won't let you. Besides, what for?
For writing songs on ranch time.
You little tattletale, I'll get you. Roy, honest, I did it on spare time, so help me, I did.
From now on, you'll have a lot of spare time. In Hollywood, writing songs for me.
Oh, Cookie, Cookie, come too. You're going to be famous.
Oh, Hollywood, swimming pool, lights,
and girls.
Yeah.
We better get started.
Oh, hold here,
the baby. Get on top of
it. Oh, my hat, my hat, my hat.
Thank you.
Light should have been here a long time ago. We better get Trigger inside.
I guess we have.
Hey, fellas, give us a hand. Bring some ropes and the whip.
Rogers was smarter than that, but we still got Trigger. We won't have him long, because now they force us to get rid of him.
Hey, what's going on here?
Don't do that. Where's the money?
They oughtn't to do that to us.
Well, Trigger, old fella, looks like they let you do it.
Guess you was right. Better do your stuff. All right, boys, get your shovels. We've got to bury the evidence.
Ted, you crippled little... How did you get in here?
Nobody's with me, Lige. I'm alone.
Well, how did you know where we were?
I figured when Ed was killed that you had something to do with Trigger. So I followed Pop here.
I read somebody.
Real McCoy. Where'd you get it, kid?
A chicken from Roy's desk. I knew you wanted it.
Well, I'll be damn burned if you ain't the smartest youngin' in the whole wide west.
Ted, I knew old Lige's training at Tramp on you sooner or later. From now on, we're working together. Is that right, boys?
You betcha.
And this money's gonna give us a good start.
What about Trigger?
Stay away from him, Ted. He's a killer.
He won't hurt me, Lige. Will you, Trigger? I miss you a lot.
All right, boys, pack up. We're coming out here.
Well, how'd it go?
It didn't. I'm sorry, Roy, but they'll contact us again. They want that money.
Well, at least we still have the money to give them. I sure hate to tell Ted.
So that's where you've been hiding your loot.
Right.
A regular thief.
Folks' handkerchief.
Somebody's boot.
Pop's glove.
What this is.
Looks like something's been cut out of here.
The ransom note.
couple of hours.
There's your evidence.
I don't believe it. Do you, Roy?
It was Pop and Lige who stole Trigger and killed Ed, all right. Trent must have taken this from Pop's office the day Ted went to visit him. That was the day I picked up the money at the bank.
So now they have Trigger and $100,000.
Well, the kid's gone. There's no doubt about that. But why did he leave Tramp?
I don't know. They were pretty smart, sending the boy here to spy on you. And then when he saw how things were going, skip up with the money.
Tramp seems to think you're wrong, Sheriff.
What are we going to do now?
Wait for another contact. That's all we can do.
We're not waiting for anything, Sheriff.
Tramp, you never left Ted for anything unless you went to steal something. Now go find him for me, will you?
I'll find him.
Trigger. Trigger's all right. Thanks for taking me, Roy, but you shouldn't have done it.
was a bad boy. I took the money so I could get Trigger back. Honest, I did.
I know, Ted. You're all popping lines.
Rounded most of them up. Popping lines are still missing.
They took the North Trail. I heard them say so.
Take care of him, Cookie. He's been a brave boy. Oh, boy. I'm sure glad to see you, Trigger. We've got to hurry. We've got a date on the North Trail. Kid like Ted had to get himself mixed up with a no-good guy like you.
Just a minute, young fella.
Huh? Attaboy, Pop. Now, Pop, let him have it.
Sure, I'll let him have it. Let him have everything.
just as good as anybody.